Today I'm going to show you how to do a textured background with aluminum foil, and it's a really fun project and just really a lot of fun. I love the way that they turn out. So I'm choosing to do my project on a piece of cardboard, and I'm going to cut out a shape, and I'm going to do a heart today. So I went ahead and pre-cut a pattern, and just any cardboard to do, you know, this is just a box that I had and I just cut it up. So you're just going to trace your shape, or maybe you're going to hand do a shape, you know, whatever you'd like. I went ahead and pre-cut this out, but so you're just going to trace it and cut it out. And the thing about cardboard is it's got a couple layers. So what I did was going to rip that top layer, and it will show you this, it will give you this in-between texture, and it's got, let me get some ripped back here. It's got these little lines in here, if I can get to it. There we go. Let's see this side. And it's just that top layer. You want to be careful not to start ripping the bottom layer. There we go. And just slowly ripping back until you get the texture you want, and it'll start to show you these lines in there. And I mean, you don't have to peel it up, but I wanted that extra, I want as much texture as I can get to my textured background. So you can peel it up as much as you want, but that gives you an idea how to do that. So again, I've already pre-cut mine. I've already took the top layer out, and this is what I have. And like you see, I didn't tear off all of it, because again, I just wanted it here and there, and that gave you those nice little nice lines in there. If I just throw it around. So this is what I'm going to start with, and I went ahead and started picking some embellishments to add even more texture to my background. And I know I want to use these flowers in there. I'm going to do a steampunk with a couple, you know, adding some flowers in there, kind of mix it up a little bit. So this should be fun. So I know I'm going to kind of have it right in there. The first thing I want to do before you start adding your embellishments is to apply some adhesive down, and I'm going to go ahead and use Mod Podge. That way it gives me some time, you know, before it dries, to kind of lay down what I want to use. So I'm just going to, I have some homemade Mod Podge here, so I'm just going to put a layer on here. Doesn't have to be too much, but you know, a good coat so it can hold the materials down a little bit. Now I'm going to be covering this with aluminum foil, so it'll have that extra hold for some of the elements that I'm going to put down. So there you go, that's good right there. All right, so I know I wanted to use these, so I'm going to put that somewhere around in there. Yeah, it's going to go somewhere around in there, I think. Okay, all right. Good elements to use, buttons, paper clips. Got some of these I'm going to use. Old Coke can top. I mean, really just anything that has, you know, design to it or texture. So let's see, some of the small ones maybe. Of course these would be attached together. Somehow attached. There we go. And let's see. And of course, some little steampunk gears. All right, let's see. And color is not going to matter. Again, it's going to be covered with aluminum foil. So I'm just looking at the design of it and that kind of thing here. So this is the time to pull out all the little this and that you might have. buttons in here. Different sizes, different grooves that are on those would be really good. And again, I'm just randomly placing these. Kind of going with it here. Let's get some little paper clips too. I love these little things. I think these were from Tim Holtz, his collections. Love his stuff. Let's just put some here and there. There we go. Oh, and he, cute. Pulling elements that I want to use. What else can I put on here? Some more gears. Never go wrong with more little steampunk gears. I think I purchased these at Michael's. Yeah, Michael's. And pick them up in their jewelry section. That's really cute. All right, I think I got a good amount of stuff just kind of laid out here and there. I like it, I like it. I always think of more stuff to put on here. I do have some random little teeny beads. I think I'm gonna place a couple spots. I'll give, and see where the glue sticks there. And it doesn't matter on color. There we go. There we go. All right. I do get a little bit more glue right over here in this corner so I can get stuff right on the edge. Yeah. Oh, I keep finding more spots, finding more spots. think that'll be good. So I still want to see some of the cardboard in the background there. Let me clean this up real quick. All right. That's good. That's good. All right. So now I have kind of a good thing down there. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to apply glue on top. Let's see. Yeah, that's what I thought. Let me dry this just a little bit to help keep everything in place. So pardon the noise. Once I start putting the aluminum foil on there, it'll help spread it around. Go. I want to make sure to get some glue around the edge, all the way around. And again, I'm just using some Mod Podge. Like a big mess right now, but trust me, it looks so cute when it's done. Bunch of wonderfulness underneath. And we're going to add our aluminum foil here. All right, so for aluminum foil, you can go the cheaper route. I got this for probably 97 cents, I think it was, at Walmart. I mean, there are thicker all the way up to the heavy duty aluminum foil. And it just really depends on how much pressure you push down and you know, with that, but we're going to be painting over this, so if I do have any rips or tears, I can cover it. It really won't, you know, won't be that too big of a deal, so this thinner, kind of cheaper will be just fine. So I'm just going to rip off a piece here, and I'm going to kind of give it just a little crinkle here, I mean, just to kind of get some good little spots in there. All right. And once I have that, I'm just going to kind of lay it on down there. And as I'm doing that, I just want to kind of squish in there. All right. Get it good and stuck on there. There we go. Now, you can go ahead and fold it over if you want to, and apply it to the back of your project as well. I mean, it's up to you. I mean, you can just cut off the edges, and that's probably what I'm going to do. But right now, I'm just working it down, pushing it straight down. I really don't want to move everything. It wasn't fully glued down, but just want to kind of start seeing the items that I put down below. So I'm just pushing down, and you could start to see all the elements underneath. You see all the different shapes of it. Like here, you can tell I'm starting to get that key and the button there in the corner. That's where my outside shape is. I like to use my hands for this. Some people choose to use, you know, different little tools and to really get in the grooves. you could accidentally, you know, cut into your aluminum foil. So I wouldn't recommend using that for this type project. I mean, you feel it, but I can actually feel how hard I'm pressing down and where exactly I'm pressing. Rub it in there so you get all the texture of that flower. It has some really pretty lines on it. There we go. I want to get in between all my little elements too, because I want to pull up that cardboard lines. I did get kind of a little tear underneath the key, but again, once I put the paint on, you won't see that really much. That chain. Again, just kind of working it through. This is probably your most time consuming right here of the project. Just making sure, because all that stuff I put down, I really want to show all the detail in there. Super cute. Another little tear right there, but that's okay. All the little beads. Oh, so cute. Can right there. There's another flower. So pretty. So still working in there. Want to get every little crease right in there. Alright, so I'm ready to apply my paint. Everything is stuck down really good. Okay, so a little of this color here. Yeah. So right now, the first thing I do is just apply the colors. And I mean, you can choose other colors. I mean, this is just what I chose. And I'm going to wet my brush really good. And start with the blue here. And you're going to apply right to your aluminum foil. I'm kind of dabbing in there so I can get in between all the little grooves there. Alright. And wet my brush again. Get some of this teal color in here. I think this is one of my favorite colors. Get it to where it kind of blends in there. Do the same thing, some lighter color in here just to give a little dimension there. I'm just gonna leave that color on there. I'm gonna go back to the dark. Some right in there. Make sure you get your edges really good. Okay. little bit more of that light color. So just not too much there, but here we go.
It's bold. I found it.
This up a little bit. All right, now I want to make sure that this is completely dry. So pardon the noise again, I'm going to dry this off really quick. One thing about acrylic paint is it's very quick to dry, so that's perfect for this project. Okay, so now I have it all colored the way I want. The next thing you're going to want to do is you're going to get black paint. And again, this is just acrylic paint, nothing special here. So I'm going to coat the entire top of this. And I know it's kind of, oh gosh, I just covering up my artwork there. Okay. And I want this, I don't want it to dry, so I want to coat the entire piece here fairly quickly, and I really want to push, I want to make sure it gets in all the grooves of this here. Here we go. Go. Around the corners there. Here we go. All right. Here we go. Let's get the majority of that cleaned up. All right, so the next thing I'm going to do is grab a baby wipe and
No! Those are not there.
All right, so as it's still wet, you want to take your baby wipe and you're going to just start taking the paint off. You're just grabbing that paint up. And I'm just pushing there. I don't want to wipe it all. Wipe it. I just want to start grabbing that paint. Here we go. I'm going to kind of pinch a little bit, some of it. Again, don't want to wipe it too much. Put some more black on there. There we go. You just keep dabbing it over and over. And what this is doing is basically you're just getting the surface. Grab another wipe here. And still keeping all the black paint inside the little like crevices. That way it helps make it pop so you can see the individual things that you put down. And you're going to keep doing this until you've taken off as much, you know, that you want to take off, the, you know, the look that you're going for. And then two, how much paint you want to show through. That's why too, it helps to make sure it's still white, wet paint, and that will help pick all of it up. Picking it up here, pushing down. This will also help push down, still squishing down that aluminum foil. Now, the more that I do this, it can start picking up your colors as well. So, that's good there. Still want to keep, I just filled up to that blue paint. Oh. Stuck to my hand, still got glue on my hands, I guess. Trying to get right in that bruise there. Take some more since I peeled up a couple more than I wanted in that spot. I'm going to take that blue and put some of this teal lighter color in there and then go back over it. Which you can, you know, happens. It got stuck on my finger. So I'm just going to put some more of that on there. Clean my brush real quick. That would dump it right in there, but don't waste that paint. Oops, that's a little too much, but that's okay. So it'll be all right. So I'm going to re-dry this. This paint up. I am making a mess today. All that waste paint. If I had my little book of wasted paint, I can pick that up. But all right, let me dry this really quick. Again, the noise. Right there, but it'll be okay. All right. And then your black paint. The mess I am making. And then I'm just going to put it just over here in the spots. Again, dabbing it in there. And little spots that I put that on there. There we go. And take your wipe, white silhouette, and just dab it on there. Just enough to get paint off the top, just like we did earlier, before I mess it up. There. I mean, you're still gonna have, you know, where the aluminum foil shows, and that it does give a really neat, you know, dimension, since you've got, you know, the different colors, and you got the black, and then we'll have some of the foil show through. Oh, so pretty. Love it. That's already dry right there. All right. Here we go. I like it. All right, and that part is done. Here we go. All right, next thing. Now, you can embellish this on the top side as well. You know, if you wanted to take it any further to really make it stand out. One thing which would be really good is applying some kind of metallic to the top to really make those elements that you put in there stand out. And clean up my mess here again. Okay. All right. So I'm going to take some of this silver and gold distress stain that I have, and I'm going to just kind of run it over the top. And I'm just going over the tops of some of the elements. Yeah. That way it just catches just some of the edging of the things that you put down. Really makes it stand out. This also too, if you didn't want, you know, depending on the colors you chose, didn't want the silver from the aluminum foil to show through, this could, you could kind of cover it up with another paint on top. For this, I want both the silver and some of this. This is the gold. Yeah.
Gold.
So it does give kind of a shimmer, and I want more on this flower right here. Oh, I just love how this turned out.